Lisa and Darnell there, really disappointed. Like, Lisa asked him to sort it out, and he clearly wasn't doing anything. What was he playing
at? He's almost sort of comatose at this stage. He couldn't be lying back more. You know, his body language is completely laissez-faire. I have just collapsed. I just can't be bothered. He's taking no control when he needs to show support, particularly to the housemates in hell, who are having a particularly hard time.
Really,
and he's showing none of it at all. No leadership at all.
No, he shouldn't be being one of the gang. He should take charge and be strong.
That's his role.
Yeah, pretty weak behaviour there. So we've seen him from democratic to laissez-faire. Doesn't stop there, no, because he goes into autocratic mode in this clip. Let's have a look.
Sarah, where's my rice at? Come on.
Well,
what
do you want?
Are you supposed to make me some rice?
Do you want tuna or...?
I want all of it. I want it now.
Is it warm?
Huh?
Is it warm?
Have you actually done this
before? Sure?
Yep. Positive.
I think you're quite a little domesticated body.
Is she hell?
On the side.
What are you doing with that? Whose is that?
That's just whoever wants it.
Why?
What?
Not a fan,
Darnell.
No. You made it again, you don't even want it?
Yeah.
Oh.
In the pan.
Oh, Darnell.
What have you done?
Power corrupts.
He's not doing himself any favours there. Just as he was becoming to be one of my favourites, he's just, you know, being spoiled, effectively.
He's let himself down. It's like he's almost suddenly remembered he has to be leader, and so he's garnered all this power together and become autocratic. I mean, it's a difficult situation for him. It's not an easy and enviable task, because when he was elected, he didn't know the house was going to be divided into heaven and hell. So he just, it's almost impossible to manage two completely disparate, divisive groups. Yeah. And he's gone through that whole
they've
range.
They've both got different aims and sort of objectives.
Yeah, but he's got to remember he's leader of the whole house and not just heaven, which is what
he's
behaving like
now.
You
should try and unite them. Was Dale right, though? You know, does power corrupt, essentially?
Well, it's certainly gone to his head, and I think he's beginning to understand something about himself. He thought he was going to be democratic. It hasn't been that easy. It's been quite tough. There's lots of curveballs thrown at him, and he's sort of imploding, really. He's now not able to take leadership on his shoulders.
No, it's difficult. I mean, he started off, you know, when he was elected, saying he feels like Obama, and it's obviously not as easy as it looks, and he completely messed up the shopping task. Do you think that's put his head on the chopping block this week?
I think it has, because food is such an enormous commodity in the house, and if you mess that up, I mean, it's tantamount to putting yourself up for nomination. No, I mean, he really did make a mess of that.
Oh, God. I hope it's not ding-dong death sentence for Darnell. I hope not.
Watch this space.
Now, Dale is the new head of house. He came into power last night. Do you think he'll make a good leader?
He's very popular, and he's very likeable, and he's very good-looking, which always helps. I think they'll cut him a lot of slack as a leader because he's popular. I don't know that he's got the strength. I think he'll probably end up being a laissez-faire leader as opposed to a democratic leader. I think we'll have to see. I wish him luck.
He doesn't strike me as the most articulate either. He's not very good at getting his point across. Do you think he'll come a cropper?
He's got determination. I'll say that for him.
He
wants to be a leader. He's tenacious. Yeah, I think he probably will come a cropper, sadly.
Actually, part of me just thinks he'll be fine because everyone fancies him.
That will certainly help him along his way, and he is definitely fanciable. So that is going to help
torso.
Him.
So, now, who do you think would make the best leader in the house?
I actually think Stu would probably make the best leader.
Stu? He doesn't do anything or say anything.
I think
he'd be laissez-faire to the max.
I think he could flourish. Either him or possibly Lisa.
Lisa's got strong skills.
She's a very strong girl. She has flourished post-Mario, and I think, you know, she's fair and she's great with the shopping. You know, they need someone to take control of that shopping and foods.
She's really coming to her own. And thank you so much for being back
pleasure.
Here. And that's Joe Hemmings,
thank
everyone.
You.
Great as always. So good.
Time now to go from their psychology to pure voyeurism with Mark Perrin, the camera on net. Mark, how are you?
Well, I feel like David Attenborough here. Okay. What I'm noticing is Hell's bedroom looks like a bomb's hit it. It really looks like the Big Bang, the start of the universe. And in fact, I can see Rachel there. The question for me is her bum getting sore from sitting on the fence?
And David, what's Mikey doing down there?
He's being a wee little moggy again. It's a primitive sound coming from Mikey. He's bending under the bed, doing all...
Is he trying to get under it? What's he trying to do?
I think it's an early form of evolutionary movement. It is anticipated that one day these creatures will actually walk on two legs.
No way. This is incredible. David, will you promise to keep an eye out for anything curious and different going on in the house?
I won't.
What's Darnell? Darnell seems to just fold endlessly. All I ever see is Darnell just folding.
Darnell is a curious species. There's going to be much written about Darnell in future generations. He's folding a sheet. Or is it a shirt? We're not quite sure.
OK, all right, David, you keep an eye on that for us, fella. Big thank you to him. We'll be hearing more from him later on, or maybe he'll be someone else. Who knows? After the break, the spotlight falls on Big Brother lovey Belinda. Don't go anywhere, darlings. Welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. It's day 46, the time now, 1:14. You'll be pleased to know, everybody, Rex has just been telling the most boring story ever about a £13,000 oven that can cook a whole chicken in 20 minutes. Best bit, you can even choose the colour of the skin. How about that, eh? Fascinating. 2 weeks ago, our next guest burst into the house full of joy and song. Sadly, on Friday, she was evicted with 65% of the vote. Please welcome the drama queen herself, Belinda, Belinda, Belinda!
Hello, how are you doing?
How are you, Belinda?
Good, thank you. I am delicious.
You're delicious, are you? Delicious. Like those chickens out of his oven.
Goodness me, what happened to Darnell? No potatoes. I couldn't believe it.
I know.
No baked beans. No.
Very tough for him.
Hard, though.
For all of them, actually.
And anyone who's being head of house. I mean, one always says, oh, God, Darnell. It must be incredibly hard for him. But it's hard for anybody being head of house, I think.
Indeed.
It's a huge responsibility.
We'll talk about that a little later on. Before we get into everything, should we just remind ourselves of the moment when Belinda left on Friday?
It's not over until Belinda sings. Thanks. Belinda's coming out!
You have been evicted. Leave the Big Brother house. You have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house.
Let's talk about heaven and hell. How was that for you?
Did you see that?
Did you see? No, that? I saw you were heroic.
I pushed myself physically where I have never been in my life before.